ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Robot Wars Armourgeddon Series 28, Heat O, the penultimate heat of this series, and I promise you it won't be a disappointment. Let's see who's in this heat. In this heat, we have AT-15, our number 3 seed, versus a newcomer in Ragnarock, Tornado, another newcomer, going up against another newcomer in Big Meanbot. That should be a good fight. Puck, all the way from London, from Silvertardis, going up against Spikaan Evolved. And first, we have the number 30 seed, Steve, up against Ripper.
Seeded number 30, Steve.
It's 96 grand and it's armed with a huge CO2 powered flipper capable of flipping anything out of the arena, but the supply is limited.
Ripper.
It looks good with a big powerful CO2 flipper and it's heavy as well at 95 grams, but it's got holes in the armor plating. Why?
Rubeteers, stand by.
Steve's the number 30 seeds with a big flipper. Speaking of flippers, we've also got Ripper.
3, 2, 1, activate.
Steve, the seeded machine, seed number 30, entered with Cruncher last time around. Flipping themselves up and over, but flipping over Ripper. Ripper, of course, unseeded, newcomers. And seemingly having a problem self-righting, finally self-righted there. Trying to get that flipper in underneath, but once again missing. And a great flip again there by Steve, but Steve's flipper keeps flipping it over, itself over. Whenever it flips its opponent, Ripper trying to self-right. Now they need to fix that problem. They seem to have a problem self-righting here. And Steve, maybe they're trying to help them out. Oh, and in doing so, they flip themselves onto their side. Oh, goodness gracious me, and they're out! Steve have gone!
Cease.
The seed and the machine have gone and Ripper will go through to the next round. I don't believe it. An absolute shock in the making and a huge upset there. Number 30 seed Steve get flipped out by Ripper. Ripper go through to the heat final. And next up we have Puck versus Spikaan Evolved. Another machine made by Silvertardis. This one's a full-bodied spinner. It's very deadly and it's very effective, but it's difficult to control at times.
Spikaan Evolved.
It has tough, strong armor, so a strong build behind it, and a very powerful flipper. However, the flipper itself has accuracy problems because of how narrow it is.
Rubeteers, stand by.
So the full-bodied spinner of Puck and the flipping bar of Spikaan Evolved.
3, 2, 1, activate.
Puck spinning up to speed, and there's Spikaan Evolved with a good attack there, and deflecting the power of Puck's full-bodied spinner quite easily. Puck, of course, from London, created by Silvertardis. Actually, one of the 3 robots from Silvertardis to enter this series. Look there at the flipping power of Spikaan Evolved. And Puck, well, it can run both ways up. It can't spin as well upside down, but it can run both ways up. But Spikaan Evolved for me is dominating, but they shouldn't have flipped them back like that, because that means they can spin up to speed, but they're not giving them a chance to spin up to speed. Finally, they spin up to speed again. Look at that. But again, just being deflected. That blade isn't the most powerful of full-body spinners, is it? And a backflip. What a backflip there by Spikaan Evolved, who's now flipped himself up and over, needs to self-right, and do so. Brilliant stuff there. Oh, flipping malfunctions flipper. Brilliant. Good little tap there. Malfunction, wasn't happy with that. Flipping him back, and Refbot giving him a yellow card. Driving into him, literally, to give him a yellow card. Brilliant. Up goes the flipper once again, and Spikaan Evolved, and what is malfunction doing? That is completely against the rules. Get back to your CPZ. Refbot bashing him back in there, making sure he stays in there. I think he just gave him a red card, actually. Yeah, he did. He just gave him a red card. Oh, okay. Puck. So, meanwhile, okay. Well, red card for malfunction. First red card of the series. There's the pit release button going down. And Puck, I'm sorry. I can't see it getting back from there. It's on its side. I'm nearly landing back on its wheels there, actually. But Spikaan Evolved just stopped it. But now they have landed back on their wheels. Oh, will Spikaan Evolved go down? Oh! Puck, I thought for a minute there I had it, and Puck, you've only got to get one good shove in, and you've done it! Oh my lord! Have they done it here, Puck? Oh no, they've both gone down!
Cease.
And what happens here? It's going to go to the judges. Let's just see this one more time. Look at this. It's going to go to the judges. Spikaan Evolved nearly in the pit. And Puck coming in out of nowhere, pushing it down, but fell in at the same time. Both hit the ground at the same time. So it's going to go to the judges. Well, the judges have made their decision. And judging upon the fact that Spikaan Evolved was immobilized on the pit first, they say that Puck go through! And that is a huge shock! Spikaan Evolved out, Puck through to the next round. And next up, we will see Tornado go up against Big Mean Bot.
Tornado.
It could whip up a storm with its interchangeable weaponry, four-wheel drive, and great speed and power, but its wheels are exposed, so it's vulnerable to axes.
Big Mean Bot.
It is big and mean with its bidirectional axe and its hefty weight of 95 grams, but the weapon accuracy is a bit off for me.
Rubeteers, stand by.
So we have Tornado with the interchangeable weaponry, and Big Mean Bot with that big axe.
3, 2, 1, activate.
Tornado speeding up the speed, 10 centimeters per second across the arena floor. Big Mean Bot with that nasty looking axe weapon, double axe, look at that. Look at the speed of it. It's quite a nice looking design too, but it's being shunted all around the arena here by Tornado. And Tornado now giving, wow! Giving Katrina a run for her money, pushing her around the arena, hitting the permanent release button. This is a great tactic here. Look at the drive, look at the power of Tornado. Absolutely dominating this match so far. Katrina going back to her side of the arena. Towards her CPZ. Watch out, ref bot, Big Mean Bot. Oh no!
Cease.
What happened there? Big Mean Bot nearly went down. Let's see this again. Look here, here's the push. Big Mean Bot. It looked like Big Mean Bot was going to go in. But somehow, Tornado goes underneath and lands in the pit first. So Big Mean Bot make it through to the next round. Tornado catastrophically fail in accidentally pitting themselves whilst attempting to pit Big Mean Bot. Big Mean Bot go through to the next round. And next up we have the number 3 seed, AT15, versus Ragnarock.
Ragnarock.
It's not the fastest, it's just 10 centimeters per second, but it has got a very deadly looking axe and it has got very strong armor as well. But they are an experience of the war zone.
Seeded number 3, AT-15.
They are our number 3 seeds with their big, powerful spinning disc and their hefty weight of 99 grams, but they are front heavy because of their weaponry.
Rubeteers, stand by.
AT-15, the number 3 seeds with that big spinning disc and the wedge. And Ragnarok with the axe weapon.
3, 2, 1, activate.
Ragnarok the first to move with that powerful axe weapon, but there's AT-15, new and improved for the last time we saw it, with a much more powerful blade, they say, this time around. There's the blade spinning at the spin, you can see why they said it was more powerful. Look down, they managed to flip them over immediately. The old blade was also capable of doing that, but it kept breaking off. This time they've made it much more sturdy and much more powerful at the same time. And they've also got a wedge at the back to help topple robots over, and a much more reliable self-righting mechanism. And they're slamming in here with that disc. But Ragnarok's axe now crashing down on the back wedge of AT-15. AT-15 trying to get his wedge underneath to flip them over, probably pushing them into Matilda's CPZ corner patrol zone. Ragnarok getting away though. Good driving there by Ragnarok to get away. And Matilda should not be attacking him. He's not in the CPZ. My house robots are very naughty. Oh dear. Anyway, in comes the axe now. The disc on the axe. There we go, that's better. Ragnarok being chopped up, but couldn't get hit there because of the wedge. there's the axe. Now, is the axe still mobile? Yes. For a minute, I thought it had broken. It was drooping down. But there's the blade once again of AT-15 flipping over Ragnarok. And now it's on its side and it can't sell far from its side. It's the pit release button. Down will go the Pit of Oblivion. Who's going to win this one? I think I have my answer already, to be fair. AT-15 has Ragnarok on its side. And Ragnarok cannot sell far from there. But it rights it for some unknown reason. I do not know why they did that. Ragnarok now trying to get its axe into play. But Ragnarok getting hit once again near the edge of the Pit of Oblivion. Oh, so close to the pit. And again, right on the edge of it. Right on the edge. There's the axe weapon. And they're on the verge of going down. And down goes Ragnarok at 80-15. Chucks itself in afterwards. Here it is again. Hits them on their side. And shoves them in. And 80-15 go through to the next round. Ragnarok gets absolutely chewed up by 80-15 and pitted. 80-15 go through to the next round where they will face off against Puck. But first up we have Ripper versus Big Mean Bot.
Rubeteers, stand by.
So we have Ripper the Flipper and Big Mean Bot the Big Axe.
3, 2, 1, activate.
Big Mean Bot was very lucky to get through the last round, but then again, so was Ripper. Ripper was being dominated and was lucky. Ah! Oh! Well!
Cease.
They certainly proved themselves a sturdy, decent robot then. Look at this again. It's got straight underneath, flipped it over once, flipped it over again, and out of the arena. Wow. Ripper showing a huge, immense show of power there, flipping Big Mean Bot out almost immediately. They go through to the Heat Finals, where they will face off either against 80-15 or Puck. Let's go to the arena to see which one he will be facing.
Rubeteers, stand by.
Puck, with its big four-body spinner, and 80-15 are number three seeds. About to dish it out.
3, 2, 1, activate.
Puck, you know, has to show its power to me. It didn't look very impressive in the last round. Was lucky to win on the judge's decision. 80-15, meanwhile, the number three seed dominated. Here's the pit release button, though. Puck, that was good of them. But 80-15 coming in on the attack with that blade. I don't know if they're going to be able to flip or get a hold of Puck very easily. But Puck is still yet to do any real damage to any of its opponents. And 80-15 is just deflecting it all again. Oh my goodness me, then look at that shot there from Puck. And will that do it? No, I don't know. Well, 80-15 have righted themselves now. But that shot from Puck was a great shot, and that definitely evened things up a little bit, but now they're close to the pit. No, they get away. And once again, Puck coming in. Oh, and 80-15 nearly in the pit then. Did you see that? Goodness gracious me. Puck, don't fly towards the pit in!
Cease.
Puck and Puck have gone down. Oh, dear. Let's see this again. It looked like they had 80-15 on the run several times. But then went and drove themselves down. And 80-15 go through to the Heat Final. Puck put up a good fight, but in the end was nudged daringly towards the pit and fell in. Out they go. And 80-15 goes through to the Heat Final to face off against Ripper.
Rubeteers, stand by.
80-15 are number three seeds with a big cutting disc. And Ripper the Flipper looking to flip them out of the arena like it did with Big Mean Bot.
3, 2, 1, activate.
Both robots could do. Oh! 80-15 immediately flipped up and over itself, writing. But Ripper getting that flipper underneath. Ripper was very impressive in the Heat semi-final. But not so impressive in its first fight. But then again, 80-15 was very impressive in its first fight, but not very impressive in the last fight of it. Look at that blade in now, and I'd say Ripper's definitely on top at the moment, and Ripper is doing all the work here for me. Ripper coming in with that flipper, 80-15 on its side. AT-15 hooked up into the air. Now, what's happening to Ripper? Ripper, oh, for a minute I thought it was immobilised. It seemed to be stuck on the inner side wall there. But that has allowed AT-15 to get an advantage shot in and chewing up the side. Look at that. And now Ripper being hooked up by Sir Killalot. The lance under the flipper. It was in the CP's head, so that was completely fair. And Killalot has flipped it up and over. Repbot saying, now, however, you've taken it out of the CP's head, you must let it go. So Killalot trying to let it go, but can't. Seems to get the angle of it. Now, Ripper far. Oh, Ripper's righted. Ripper was lucky there to come back into this one. And AT-15 pushing it back into the CP's head. And there's a sandwich now between AT-15 and Sir Killalot. And number three seeds, I would definitely say, have come back into this one now. And have evened things up a little bit. Maybe even managed to make it on top. I think they are now on top of this one. This is all AT-15's match. AT-15 is chewing them up with that spinning disc. Look at that. Meanwhile, Sir Killalot's lance has come off. Look at that. AT-15, meanwhile, now flipping Ripper up and over. Now we know how much problems Ripper has with self-righting. Look at that, it's a huge bundling. There's like hamsters bundling up, except these are a little bit less fluffy than hamsters and a lot more deadly. And Sir Killalot shobbling now on the flipper. Oh, Ripper. Ripper cannot self-right from that position, I don't think. Or can it? No. Ripper having difficulty self-righting here. AT-15 now chewing up the back. AT-15 for me is definitely on top here. Ripper is stuck in a position where it cannot self-right from. Refbot, if they drive backwards, they will be okay. Ooh. Now, is Ripper okay now? I'm not too sure. This has all been AT-15 for me since that. And AT-15 pushing them back in towards the CPZ. Refbot was having a look at counting them out. Ripper now. Oh, look at the damage caused by Sir Killalot's claw. Just going straight. And look at the crevasse torn out of them. And they've been flipped over once again. And AT-15 mauling them against the arena side wall. Will this one go to the judges? If so, then surely this one has to have been won by AT-15, who is mauling Ripper up here. Ripper self-righting, but being mauled up once again. Sir Killalot now trying to get a grasp of Ripper. And crutching into the flipper. Cease. And cease is called. This one will go to the judges. And for me, there was only one winner now. AT-15 dominated the fight towards the end of that one. Well, the judge's decision is in. And based on style control, damage and aggression, they have gone for a number three seed, AT-15. No surprises there. They go through to the series semi-finals. Join us next time for the very final heat, Heat P. I've been your host, Anderson9132. Thank you very much for watching, and goodbye.